Good morning, you're watching Proactive London, and from Caledonia Mining, Mark Learmonth, the CEO, joins me. Good morning, Mark. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you. Thank you for having me, Chris. Nice to be here.
Yes, glad to have you back. Now, I know you've been speaking to Proactive London a little while ago, but you and I haven't chatted for a little while. But let's just fill ourselves in on the details, because Caledonia is just announcing quarterly and annual production figures from your Blanket Mine in Zimbabwe. Maybe for our viewers, you can expand on some of the detail and give us some of the highlights.
Yeah, we announced production for the year and the quarter. Critically, production for the year was just over 80,000 ounces, about 80,700 ounces, which was slightly ahead of our guidance range. The guidance range, I think the top end was 80,000 ounces. But critically, what's really important is it demonstratively marks the fact that we've achieved our long-standing production target, which we've had since 2015, of achieving 80,000 ounces a year from the mine. So we've increased production over the course of the last sort of 5 or 6 years from about 50,000 ounces up to this level of 80,000 ounces on completion of the central shaft. And it really sort of marks it's an important milestone in that we've achieved this long-standing production target, which clearly means more ounces, more cash. But also because the central shaft is a more efficient way of running, it means that we can it does blunt somewhat the inflationary pressure that we, along with all other miners, are seeing in our input costs. So that kind of moves me onto a discussion of costs, which we also disclose. But also in the press release, for the first time, we give guidance as to the production from what we call the Bilboes Oxide project. Now, about a week or so ago, we announced that we completed the acquisition of the Bilboes project, which is a large sulfide resource about 75 kilometers north of Bulawayo. It's got about 2.5 million ounces of sulfide. But in the short term, we're also able to extract gold from what's called the oxides, which is a shallower layer of surface or near surface material, lower grade. And we have to move that material anyway, obviously, to get to what's underneath it, the sulfides. And by doing that, by removing those oxides and by processing them, we can this year extract anything between 12 and 17,000 ounces of gold from those oxides. And that project will continue for the next two and a half years. So the production on a consolidated basis, production for 2023, say 70, 75 from Blanket, say approximately 15 from the oxides. You know, we're looking at materially higher production in 2023 than we achieved in 2022, which is all good. But then there's a lot in this press release. Then also, unusually, we give cost per ounce guidance, cost guidance. Now, ordinarily, we never did that in a press release because we were only talking about Blanket Mine, and the cost profile of Blanket Mine was very stable. But now that we're introducing Bilboes into the mix, the Bilboes oxides into the mix, the cost profile changes slightly because the grade of the oxides is relatively low. It's less than 2 grams a ton, whereas the grade at Blanket is material is about 3.5 grams a ton. So that means that inevitably the cost per ounce of the processing the ounces we're making from Bilboes oxides is somewhat higher than the cost per ounce that we're seeing at Blanket. Now, if we didn't explain that, when we publish our Q1 and our Q2 numbers, people are going to see the overall cost per ounce has gone up. They go, the cost per ounce has gone up. Don't panic. Actually, the cost per ounce at a Blanket is pretty much what we expect to achieve for 2022. So not actually, we're not succumbing to the inflationary pressure that other people are seeing because we've got certain sort of efficiencies built into the system. But because the costs at the oxides are so much higher, about $1,250 an ounce, on a consolidated level, it will go up. But we are making money about this gold price, $600-$700 an ounce from moving material, which we have to move anyway. So we're actually making a virtue out of a necessity. So it's quite a complex press release, but it covers quite a lot of ground. But I think those are the headlines.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I was going to touch on that. You've pretty much answered those questions for us. And investors will be keen to know about the low on-mine cost of the Bilboes project. And as you say, material you have to move anyway, and also managing to offset inflationary pressures, which may be well affecting other gold producers in and around the area. Now, you have figures in the release of around about $20 million of capital going into the assets there. Can you maybe elaborate as to where the cash is coming from and how it's going to be apportioned throughout 2023?
Well, the cash will come from the cash that generated at the mine. So, I mean, Blanket historically has been producing and making money at a rate of about $1 million a week. So that's 50 odd million dollars a year. So for 2023, certainly at this gold price, it'll be higher than that. But obviously we don't bank on a higher gold price. So about $50 million of operating cash flow coming from Blanket, which is comparable with previous years. And then about $7 or $8 million coming out of the Bilboes Oxides. So that more than covers the cost of the capital. So there's no risk to the at this stage if we achieve what we expect to achieve, there's no risk to the Caledonia dividend. And also it's fair to say that we do expect to be able to introduce some gearing into the solar project. The solar project was became operational late last year. As people will know, we spent about $14 million on that, all funded through equity. And it's unconscionable, really, for a project such as a solar project to be all equity funded. And so we would expect to introduce a modicum of debt into that, which will further improve our liquidity.
Well, it all sounds very encouraging, keeping costs low, working with efficiency, and of course, the added bonus of that solar project coming online as well. I know you're going to have a busy 2023, and all we can ask is that you keep us updated as we go forward. Once again, Mark Learmonth, CEO at Caledonia Mining, thanks for your time today on Proactive London.
Thank you, Chris.